Hi you guys. Okay, so thank you so much for tuning into my channel. This video is going to be about my relaxer. I'm going to basically walk you through what I do on my relaxed days. I relaxed my hair 5 days ago, and before I relaxed it, I was 5 months post-relaxer. I like to wait about 4 to 5 months before every time I relax my hair so that I can have enough new growth to relax my hair and that I'm not over-processing it. So, what I like to do to prep for my relaxers is I don't scratch my hair 2 days before I relax my hair, and I don't wash it, co-wash it, or put braids in my hair a week before I know I'm about to relax my hair. So the relaxer that I like to use is the Ors relaxer in normal. I use a lot of different relaxers before, but this one works best for me. It doesn't leave my hair dry like other relaxers do, so I really like that relaxer. It's a bit on the pricey side, but it's definitely worth the price. So basically, when I relax my hair, I part my hair into 4 sections, and then I set my timer on my phone. I do not relax my hair longer than 14 minutes just because I want to loosen the texture. I don't like my hair to be bone straight. I like to just loosen the texture of my hair and just make sure I have a little bit of texture left in it. So I part my hair into 4 sections, and then I apply the relaxer to my edges and my nape first, and then I proceed to relax the rest of my hair. And after I'm done relaxing, I leave it on for 14 minutes, and then I wash it out with this neutralizing shampoo. Make sure when you relax your hair that you use a neutralizing shampoo, because this is the only thing that'll stop the relaxer from processing. And when I'm using the neutralizing shampoo, I make sure that I wash my hair with this twice so I can be sure that I got all the relaxer out. Okay, so after I'm done washing my hair, I like to grab a towel and wrap my hair up in it for about 10-15 minutes to get out all the excess water. And then I condition. I condition with this olive oil conditioner. This is a good protein conditioner because when you relax your hair does lose protein, and this conditioner helps, you know, bring back protein into your hair. And I also mix that conditioner with a moisturizing conditioner just to get the best results. So after I'm done conditioning my hair, I grab the towel and I get out all the excess water again for about 10 to 15 minutes, and then I start to detangle my hair. I detangle my hair with this wide tooth comb, and then I put moisturizer into my hair. It's a leave-in conditioner, but I also use it as a moisturizer. So I put that into my hair, and then I detangle, and then before I blow dry, because after I detangle my hair, then I part my hair into 2 different sections so I can start to blow dry. And I use this as a heat protectant. This is a really good heat protectant. You just can't use too much. Because if you use too much of this heat protectant, it will weigh your hair down. And you don't want your hair weighed down before you even flat iron it. So after I put my heat protectant in, I blow dry it. And I use this blow dryer. This is Conair's blow dryer. And I like to take my paddle brush and like blow dry my hair and stretch it out. I like to stretch my roots out to make sure that they are getting straight before I flat iron. And you don't really need an expensive blow dryer. They all blow out heat, so you don't really need an expensive blow dryer. Just any type of blow dryer just to get your hair straight. So after I blow dry my hair, I proceed to flat iron it. And I use these flat irons, the Conair. Now these are some cheap flat irons. I got these from Walgreens, and they get my hair straight, and they do curl pretty, but they don't get it silky straight like I want it to be. And I think in order to get that result, you need to invest in a good flat iron, like a Chi or something, because these flat irons are like really cheap, and like they don't get my hair as straight and silky as I want them to. So if you want your hair really straight and silky, invest into a good flat iron. So after I am done flat ironing my hair, I add moisturizer, I add a little bit of this, and I add grapeseed oil to my ends to make sure that when I wrap it, that in the morning my ends are laying flat and they're not frizzy. So after I add those two things to my ends, I wrap my hair, and I tie my hair up with a satin or silk scarf. I always, always, always sleep with a satin or a silk scarf on my head, because if you sleep on cotton, it like takes the moisture out of your hair, so you don't want to have your hair rubbing against cotton while you're asleep. That's why I use a satin silk scarf when I go to sleep. And the way that I maintain my hair throughout the week or until I wash it again is by wrapping it every night. So make sure you wrap your hair every night so that you can maintain your hairstyle. So yeah, that's basically it. That's basically all I do on my relaxed days. Yeah, because I'm currently grazing bra strap length because I cut my hair. And I cut my hair because I needed a trim. And I really kind of need one again, but I'm just gonna wait till it grow out a little bit more and then cut it again. So I'll be grazing bra strap length again, basically. But yeah, so that's basically all I do on my relaxed days. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, leave them down below. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.